to Made in Science, the official podcast of the University of Stuttgart. My name is Wolfgang Holtkamp. I am Senior Advisor on International Affairs and your host for today. In this episode, we welcome Tasneem Barakat, who is an alumna of our English-speaking master's program, WASTE. Hello, Tasneem.
Hello.
The WASTE program educates students to address the environment and environmental challenges, especially in the fields of air quality control, solid waste, and wastewater process engineering. Now, out of these areas, your focus is on water. In a way, I'm not surprised. Our Earth is called sometimes the blue planet, with more than 70% of the Earth's surface covered by water. So, please, may I ask, what interests you most in the topic of water?
Yeah, good question. I would say like the water is the key of life, bring the joyful, and it's like necessary. So it was like obvious, like I like to work more with water other than the other areas.
Tasneem, you grew up in Syria. You started studying there and then came to the University of Stuttgart. But that is your life just in a nutshell. Please, would you mind introducing yourself a little more?
I would like to say I'm environmental engineer. This is my focus. And I born raised in Syria. There I studied as engineering assistant. Then civil engineering in the Department of Environmental Engineering. I had the chance to be assistant lecturer as a part to be later as a doctor and in the university. So it was interesting to be a teacher in a way of my classmates or my colleagues, my friends, younger friends. And then I realized because of the situation in Syria, Syria don't have a lot of international relations, so there is no chance to really do my higher education outside Syria with the government support. So I decided I will do it by myself. I applied for many scholarships. I got applied acceptance by DAAD, and I came to Germany. So first of all, I would like to thank DAAD to change my life. So it could be Australia or, I don't know, like Japan or Turkey, but it was Germany. And I'm really happy and satisfied here in Germany. Did my master here in Stuttgart in WASTE program. It's an international program. And now I'm working for the city of Stuttgart. And really happy in my work. It really suits my background. It's in the engineering department, specifically in apartment of fountains and drink water fountains.
Why did you apply for a job in this particular department?
It's actually like a good story. I was already in the civil engineering department in Stuttgart, in the quality management department. Unfortunately, my contract was limited, so I had to search for a new one. I found a job with a really attractive title with project manager in climate action program for City Stuttgart. It was like the dream job. It's for environmental engineer. Who cares about climate change issues and environmental area? It was for me perfect. So I applied and I get the job. It was my job. It was a part of this agreement or in a way that Stuttgart City did to make the climate change, to prevent the climate change. And it was a part of the big plan for city Stuttgart in a way to consider the Paris Agreement to prevent climate change and to reduce the temperature in the summer. So for me, it was like really attractive, and I'm really happy now.
Can you give us some examples what the city is trying addressing water and climate change?
The city has many actions in many areas. For example, more blue infrastructure in Stuttgart, and more green infrastructure in Stuttgart, and many other actions will be taking place in a way to reduce or prevent the climate change.
Given that context, what exactly are you doing in this particular frame? Is there a particular project you are working on?
We are from Department Brunnen und Gewässer, which means in English the fountains and water service. And our mission, as my mainly mission, is to build new drinking water fountains and new fountains in Stuttgart, which is like really challenging, but it's really interesting and bring me the joyful.
Tasneem, how did you even start becoming interested in engineering?
Yeah, I was raised in a house full of engineering topic. So my father has always worked in engineering sector. So he took me with him to construction sites. Also bring a lot of catalogs to pick which color of wall you would like to add, or what do you think about the new ceramic or the new trend of building. So I was like really surrounding of this area. So I would like to, so my task was, for example, at home, so he gave me paper, pencil, and say, yeah, Tasneem, now you have to draw like 3D our bookshelves. Who had designed it by himself and built it. So I was like really fascinated with the 3D drawing, with engineering, with the materials, beetles and structures, how they put the metal between the beetles, how they put the wood around the beetle. I was like really fascinated. So it was like really interesting. So I said, yeah, this is what I have passion for. So that's why I started engineering in my city homes in Syria.
In Germany, often engineering is still a male-dominated field. How's this in Syria?
I would say it depends on the engineering field. So I would say in mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, mostly really male to men, but on the other hand, maybe like environmental engineer and architecture would be like more woman to men. But I guess like IT nowadays is like half-half.
Now in Stuttgart, you work in the public sector. What are your experiences working in that particular area?
I would say it's great to work for the city because as environmental engineer, their goals is for environmental issues and environmental goals. They are like really clear, and they do a lot of environmental work just for the environmental. There is no other profit in this field. So as environmental engineer, it was like the perfect field for me, I would say. And in another hand, I would say it's like really good for families. Myself is a mother, and I couldn't do like really full job. So now I'm working with for the city where I have the flexibility. So I can say, I can go to pick my child. I would like to have like only 70% or 90%. Like, this flexibility is like really great in the public sector, where the families are taking in consideration. Also, I would like to state that there is equality or chances for all over the people are living in the Stuttgart or auch in Germany too. So this rumors is not true. So only Germans can work in public sector is not true. So I would say we are three people, like young people, I would say, from West program now in my floor working for City Stuttgart. So it's a good sign.
Tasneem, you have been involved always in voluntary work and you are still engaged in some project. Why is it important for you to help others?
Actually, like my personality takes me always to ask help if I need it. So it's no problem. There's no issue if I don't know something or I need really help to ask for it. So can I help me? And another way, if you need the help, you need to offer this help. So I would say I always will to help. And some people have not the same personality, so they don't like to come to ask for help. So I would say I'm here to help. So this is my personality and I can help. So I'm really happy to offer help for others and support them in their professional life and their daily life, if I can.
We look ahead a little bit. What is your prediction? How will Stuttgart's look change as far as water and fountains are concerned in the future?
I would love to imagine a Stuttgart with a lot of fountains, which will bring the joyful to the city, the life, and a lot of drink water stations wherever you would like to walk, so you can crave a little bit of water and a drink. So I like to imagine myself also all the time with water. It's like really bring me the satisfaction and the relaxation, and it's really interesting. Like, all the time my friends call me the duck because I like to be next to the water. The best view ever would be for me like a sea with a lot of mountains. So I would like to have this water view also in Stuttgart city.
And if you had a really good, perhaps even unlimited budget at your hands, what project would you like to realize in the city of Stuttgart?
Yeah, it's not in the fountain area, but I would like to imagine Stuttgart with a beach on the Neckar, or with a lovely coast with a lot of activities on the river. I would like to imagine Stuttgart's river just like Pons River or Frankfurt's river or Vienna's river, where you can really enjoy the water.
Coming to your personal professional life, what are your goals for the future?
Yeah, as wherever the environmental issues are matters, and my knowledge, my expertise can be important, I can just go in this direction.
The final part of our conversation addresses some questions, and we call it Moment 7. Have collected 7 questions that we would like to ask you. Please answer them as shortly as possible. Moment 1 Spätzle or Maultaschen?
Spätzle, definitely.
Moment two. One thing you could change about the world.
Yeah, the best word ever in my imagination. No boundaries, no nationalities, and no flags.
Moment three. Do you have a book recommendation for us?
Thinking Fast and Slow.
Moment four. The best advice you have ever received was?
Yeah, my doctor in the university back then in Syria, he was all the time encouraging me to do better. And he was all the time telling me, Tasneem, if you apply, you have chance to be accepted. But if you don't, there is no possibilities. So I would like to thank him because that was keeping in my head. So Dr. Aber Muhammad, he also studied here.
Moment six. If you were not an engineer, what would you be?
Interior designer.
And moment seven. Please complete the following sentence. The best thing about Stuttgart is?
The green areas.
Tasneem, thank you for having taken the time and talking with us today. We are very much looking forward to staying in touch and wish you the best of luck with everything you do. To our audience, thank you for listening again. Please feel free to subscribe to our podcast and also to rate it. Most of all, stay tuned for our conversations that are always based on what is made in science.